Hey, what's up, Nathan? This is a quick demo video for you for your KR Luke Eco V2 that I just got done today. So this is installed with a Profi V2 and CC Sabre's LED pixels in here. And this has a completely removable chassis. This is a two button setup. So what I did was I placed your buttons underneath your clamp card here. I was able to sand down your card on the underside and not have it affect the aesthetics of the outside. So your front button here, if you can hear that tactile, will be your activation. And then your back button back here, that is your auxiliary. So what we want to do is we want to open up everything from the only place that it opens, the pommel cap. And then you'll have your chassis sticking out about that far. So we're going to want to go ahead and just kind of reach in there and twist it until it comes out about that far, and then you can pull it right out. Spent some time sanding this guy and making it nice and smooth. So it does say Solo Sabres over here. You have your board right here. Easy access to your micro USB, but you would need to pop the board up to get to your SD card. It's just a press fit down into that shelf, so no glue. And then you've got your male 14 pins over here that make it possible to have this as a disconnect and then a removable battery setup. So the spring side over here, that's going to be your negative side. And of course, these pins will all line up with all those, that PCB trace or that PCB back there with all the traces on it is what lines up with this guy. So the trace back there has all your wires for your switches and your NeoPixel pins up here. And then of course, everything else is wired from here to your board. And all of those wires are right in here where you can't see them or underneath the board. So we'll throw a battery in it. Actually, before we throw a battery in it, you had voiced some concern about not wanting this guy to hit the speaker. So what I did was, after I installed this, I just went ahead for an extra security measure and I did 3D print a small ring and glued it on there, and then sanded it and polished it and everything like that. So if you can see, your speaker sitting inside there just enough to where when this thing goes all the way up on it, it will never touch that speaker drum. And that's what that's for right there. So we're going to throw a battery in it. You'll hear that. That's a good sign. Don't ever put your battery in backwards. And then we'll just go ahead and slide this guy in. It slides right in. It is a snug fit, but it goes in just like that. So we're going to go ahead and we'll get that in. It goes about that far, and then the rest of it will be pushed all the way forward by the pommel cap, right? Whoops. Let me turn this off real quick. Accidentally turned it on. Okay, so we're gonna screw this pommel cap on. As we're screwing this on, it's going to get kind of tight, but that's okay. Just go ahead and keep screwing it till it won't go anymore. And now all those pins are engaged. You do have motion control. Nice and loud. Pins are working really well. And then we could twist off. And we'll throw a battery in here. Or not a battery, sorry, a blade. So you have a blade retention screw, which is right here. You can see that little guy right there. Now I did go all the way down as far as I could in that blade socket with your PCBs so that you'd have as much bite as possible when it came to putting in a blade. So we'll just put your blade in. We'll tighten up the retention screw. Now you can see everything's working really well. Tap your auxiliary. After you hold down the auxiliary and swing. And then we twist off. Now to change sound fonts when we have the blade off, we'll just tap the auxiliary. TNC. And we can just cycle through these.
Jet smooth, smooth.
That's how you get to all of them, right?
TNC. Smooth, smooth, smooth.
We got got the two Luke fonts on here that you sent. Well, we get back to those.
Luke Skywalker.
This guy. And we'll turn it off. One more time.
I am a Jedi. Like my father before me.
Slight flicker in the blade. We do have that change in color in the blade when the blade swings. So you get kind of a white effect. It's an audio, it's a, just a responsive blade, right? And then it goes back to green when it stops. Hopefully you can see that. And we'll turn it off, just like that. And then we'll come back over here when we want to take everything out and we'll unscrew this guy. Just like that. And you might find this might be a little difficult for you to pull out. I've been able to do it with my fingernail or just by twisting it. Just like that. I do twist it as it comes out. And then it'll pop out like that. And then I can just take it the rest of the way out. This all needs to be a snug fit in order for those pins to line up properly with their traces on the inside. There's no wiggle room, right? So you want to make sure that, you know, everything's lining up, and in order to do that, it needed to be snug. And then when we take the battery out, we can just put it back in, and then you can see when you're pushing on it, excuse me, how it wants to bounce back. If you can hear that and see it at all, that's just engaging on those pins. And then we just slap this back on when we're done. But that is your saber, sir. If you got any questions, let me know. Hope it turned out the way you like. And I will get this out in the mail to you tomorrow morning. Thanks.